हेलो पूजाश्री, वी आर लाइव नाउ, यू कैन स्टार्ट।
थैंक यू। हेलो एंड गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन, दिस इज पूजाश्री एंड आई विल बी मॉडरेटिंग द सेशन टुडे। ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ फोर ऑप्टम टीम आई वुड लाइक टू वेलकम ऑल द ऑडियंस कनेक्टेड टू अस थ्रू दिस सेशन, स्टार्टिंग द सेशन विद अ ब्रीफ इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ आवर प्रोग्राम For Optum, student presentation is initiated by For Optum team, where students present on various optometry-related topic. Today, we have Ms. Sukshita YC with us. Ms. Sukshita is currently studying second year BSc Optometry in Netradama School of Optometry, Bangalore. Today, she'll be discussing on bifocals. As the session is live in YouTube, I request you all the viewers to drop any queries about the presentation in the comment box. We will be discussing about all the queries at the end of the session. Sukshita, you can take over the session now.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. Thank you, Pooja, for your kind introduction. I'm Sukshita from Netradhama, and I'm today presenting about the topic bifocals. So today we'll be discussing what are the bifocal lenses and what are the different terminologies used in bifocal lenses, different types and optical characteristics, and also we'll be discussing about advantages and the disadvantages of bifocal lenses. But before we go to bifocal lenses, let's start with what are the first choice of lens we have, that is monofocal lens or conventional lenses. When a lens has only one focal point, or rather one focal power, it is called as monofocal lenses, which you are seeing in the figure. And when a particular lens has a two different focal power, so for example, which you are seeing in the second figure, the base lens or the top lens has a different refractive power or curvature, whereas the lower part has the focal point nearer to it. So which are the particular persons who require bifocal lens? Those are presbyopic patients. So what happens in presbyopia? In presbyopia, lesser amount of accommodation occur with progressing age. So the near point of accommodation starts receding. So that's why you need a particular amount of correction for near as well. When a particular near correction is added over a distance correction, that is what is called as a bifocal lens. And the term bifocal also means no focal length. So here is an example. So here a single lens, or a rather one complete lens, will have a two different segment in which there will be two different focal length. Now we'll see the terminology. The size of the bifocal is specified by the width of the bifocal segment determined at the widest segment. The longest vertical measurement of the segment is known as seg depth. Seg height is the measurement from edge at the lower level to the top of the segment. Seg drop is the vertical component of the distance from the MRP of the segment or distance portion of the lens to the top of the seg. Here MRP refers to the mean reference point. The horizontal component distance between the MRP and the segment center is known as seg inset. Then now coming on to the types of bifocal, depending on the manufacturing procedures or manufacturing techniques, they're divided into three types. The first one is fused bifocal, and the second one is one-piece bifocal, and the third one is cemented bifocal. So we'll discuss what happens in fused bifocal. Here, what we do is we use a crown glass or a different refractive index material for the distance portion, and we make a depression into that lens, and then we insert higher refractive index material. So what happens is the refractive index for the top of the lens is different and lower portion will be higher. So at the lower part of the power of the lens would be higher and the upper portion will be having different power, and this would give you a bifocal effect. And the second is one piece bifocal. Here we grind two different curves at the upper and the lower part. So this is one of the example of how executive lenses are generally made. So it is the single piece of material, which would be either glass or plastic, and two different curvatures are grounded on distance and near portion separately. And the third type is cemented bifocal. Here, first we will take a distance portion and then take a separate button, which is cemented over through a distant part with an optical cement, which could be Canada balsam or epoxy resin, which is now generally used into the plastic bifocal, whereas Canada balsam was previously used in the glass bifocal. Now we'll see how these types of bifocals are manufactured. First, we'll see the manufacturing of the fused bifocal. As I said earlier, we take a crown glass or a lens blank, which is made up of a crown glass, and make a lens, make a depression curve into a lower part of that particular lens, which you are seeing in the picture and then take a button which is made up of a flint. Now the flint has the higher refractive index, so that the refractive power of this particular portion will be higher as compared to what you see in the ground glass. So what in this depression, so in this depression curve, what we do is we insert the button which is slightly of higher index, and that is fixed with the help of very high temperature. So the moment you put the button inside it and then insert into a very high temperature of more than 1000 centigrade, both will get fused in a particular area, which will give you a fused blank, which is seen in the second picture. After this, they again fused and grounded depending on to the power which is required onto the front and the back surface, and that would give you a bifocal lens. And this is completely a fused bifocal. Next, now how do we identify the fused bifocal from the cemented and one piece? So to identify this, when you take your finger over the surface of the lens and you will be not able to feel the button which is present, even though you can see the visibility of the lower segment, which is for reading. Now, there is something called as composite buttons. So previously, what we saw was a round segment bifocal, which is easily done with the button inserted. But what about the lenses which are made of flat top bifocal or rebel lenses? So how it is done? To create a flat top bifocal, what we do is we create again a depression and take the semicircle of the flint lens, and the above portion is filled with the help of crown glass. Now, once you insert them into a very high temperature, crown glass will get united with the base lens and only the flint lens will be visible as a segment. Here you can see the semicircle part is a flint and the upper part is a crown glass. This will be fused at a very high temperature so that the crown glass will not be visible and you can see only the flint portion. And in the second figure, what you are seeing is a rebel lens. In this lens, we create a ribbon form of shape with the help of a flint, and the upper and the lower portion is made up of crown glass. And then they're inserted and fused together at a high temperature under a vacuum. Then they will be fused properly and only the flint part will be visible in the form of the ribbon segment. Then coming on to the manufacturing of one-piece bifocal. One-piece bifocal are simply having a one single piece of material, either the plastic or a glass, and then different curvature are made over a particular area, which is for distance and the other portion is for near. So there are two examples of how they can be made. See the first one is called as a split or Franklin bifocal, or also called as executive bifocal. So here they're completely 50-50 divided. The half portion of is for distance and the other half is for the near. So the lower part will be less curve, or rather the steeper one is addition part or the reading area. And the upper part is for distance prescription. So generally the amount of correction which is to be grounded is grounded to the back surface, not to the front surface. So the complete prescription is grounded onto the back surface of the split lens. There is another example of your one-piece bifocal, that is Altex type. So in Altex, the curvature is grounded to the back surface. So whatever the prescription should be grounded is grounded onto the front surface. In split lens, we'll ground it to the back surface, and in Altex, we'll ground to the front surface. So this is how the manufacturing of one-piece bifocal is done. Next, manufacturing of cemented bifocal. As I said earlier, cementing means combining two different parts with the help of the optical cement. What happens here is we have a distance lens, which is a monofocal lens, and we take a reading button, which is made up of a different material or the same material, but with a different curvature, which is steeper. Now the upper portion has a different power, and this particular lower button has a power of around plus 2.5 diopter. So with the help of the epoxy resin or Canada balsam, which both of them are optical cement, stick this particular button into this area, and that will give you a cemented bifocal. Then segment type and optical characteristics. So depending upon the shapes, they're called with different names. The first one is the round segment. So here the optical segment or reading segment is completely round in shape. But when it is fitted onto the spectrum frame, they generally have a particular curve or a semicircle appearance, and they are also called as the Kriptok lens. And the second one is a flat top bifocal. Here the upper area of the lens is flat and the image jump is comparatively less when compared to the round top bifocal. And the third one is curved top bifocal. It is nothing but the modification of the flat top bifocal. Only thing here is upper portion is not flat, but rather it is slightly curved in nature. And fourth one is panoptic bifocal. In this, the sharp edges present in the curved top focal bifocal were further modified and made very smooth. And the next one is B segment or ribbon bifocal. It is nothing but the upper and the lower portion are cut, so it gives you a horizontal box type of appearance. So B segment are the one with a smaller width. And finally, coming to the R segment, which will be wider as compared to the B segment. So now we will see the optical characteristics of the different types of bifocal. First is the flat top bifocal. So the flat top bifocal, as you see here, the segment is present, but the top of the lens is rather flatter in nature. It is also called as D style of a straight top. And the available segment width which are present is 22, 25, 28, 30, 40, 45 mm. So the width of the near segment would be ranging from 22 to 45 mm. And the optical center lies 5 mm below the segment top. So the advantage here is, as the optical center is closer to the upper edge, the amount of the optical jump or the image jump which we have because of the prismatic effect induced would be lesser as compared to the round top bifocal. But there are also some disadvantages, that is, the reading area is somewhat reduced and the dividing line can cause certain problems. For example, like while climbing the steps or the stairs. Then curved top bifocal. Then we'll come to the curved top bifocal. It is the modified form of flat top bifocal. And available segment width is 22, 25, 28, and 40. Commonest type is 22, 25, and 28, which are generally used. And 40 is the one which is least because it is quite big and cosmetically quite blemished. Optical center lies 4.5 mm below the segment top. So the advantages what they have over the flat top bifocal is that they're cosmetically more acceptable as the curved top is not very much visible. Also, if your lenses is tilted very slightly from the right or left, it would not be very much visible. Whereas in the flat top bifocal, what happens is that if your lenses is tilted slightly, then both the lenses will not match easily and look quite cosmetically blemished. Next, we have panoptic bifocal. This is again a modification of flat top bifocal. Here all the edges and the upper area are curved. It is also called as P style. Available segment is 22 and 28. Optical center lies 4.5 mm below the segment top. The next one is ribbon segment. It is also called as ribbon because the shape which is available. If you can see here, which it looks like a small ribbon cut and stuck onto your lens. Now, two segments are available here, B segment and the R segment. B segment is 22 or 25 mm wide and 9 mm deep, and the optical center lies around 5 mm below the segment top. Then R segment, which is present, that would be 22 or 25 mm. And here the width will be it will be like 12 to 14 mm. So it is more wider. Then advantages when compared to other designees that there are some particular profession where they want to read, and at the same time from much more lower segment, they should be able to see the distance portion. So here in the R segment, what happens is when compared to the other design, there is a space down so that they can read it. Then next come to the Franklin bifocal. Franklin style bifocal are also called as executive, E-line, or full segment bifocal. It is called as full segment because the reading area is complete the width of the lens itself. Then OC, then optical center lies on the line of the bifurcation. So the advantage here is the amount of field of view which you get. The widest field of view for the near, and also there will be no image, no jump effect. But at the same time, the disadvantage we get is the demarcation line, which is quite obvious, and the weight of the lens will be quite heavy, and also the accumulation of the dust takes place, and also the edge of the segment chips easily. Then finally, coming to the round top bifocal, which is commonly used nowadays. So round top bifocal are usually made with either fused bifocal or cemented bifocal or one piece bifocal. So in the second picture, what you are seeing is not round, but it is actually semicircle, but it is also included in the round segment itself, available as A style, R40 and blended. Optical center lies at the center of the segment. Here there will be no particular thing like how much mm. And the biggest disadvantage of the round top bifocal is that we will get more amount of the prismatic jump. Now we are seeing the mechanical requirement in the bifocal. That is, bifocal lenses should not be too heavy. The segment's dividing line or a curve should be as inconspicuous as possible to maximize the prismatic success. Weight of the combination of the lens in the bifocal should not be noticeably greater than that of the equivalent lens, a single vision lens, which is for distance and near. Added segment is made circular and thin as possible with its OC coinciding with its GC, then should have good mechanical stability, should be permanent. Then optical requirement in bifocal, near vision quality should be equal to distance vision quality. Near vision point coincide with distance vision point. Vertical prismatic effect should not coincide. The two portions should provide equally clear vision, free from aberration. Now coming to the disadvantages of the bifocal lens, that is, it is convenience over two pairs. So whenever you go into the presbyopic age, why to have one separate pair for distance and near and continuous changing from one over the other? So the bifocal lens can give you the same effect which have for distance and the near. Then full clear vision in distance and near zone compared to the PPLs. Here PPL refers to the personalized progressive lenses. So in progressive lenses, as we know, at the periphery we have distortion or unwanted astigmatism, giving us the problem to look at the peripheral vision, whereas in the bifocals, we do not get such kind of problem. Rather, we have a good amount of clear vision. Some bifocals are cosmetically acceptable, for example, fused bifocal, and different adds, prism, cylinder, and axis can be incorporated into the near segment. Next, coming to the disadvantage of bifocal lenses, visible dividing line, cosmetically unappealing and annoyance to the wearer. Limited field of view in some smaller segment. Then reading portion is too low for some tasks. It arises especially in the computer workers. And if the segment is very low, the patient has to take his chin up to look at this particular point. Then intermediate vision is difficult for higher ads. Then there is weight and thickness, for example, executive bifocals. And there will be an image jump, as you can see in this picture. Then what is image jump? Prism in ophthalmic lenses is responsible for the jump in bifocal lens. Image jump refers to a sudden change in image location that occurs when gaze shifts from the distance lens to the ad segment due to the sudden introduction of the prismatic power at the top of the bifocal segment. The object of the individual sees in the inferior field suddenly jumps upward when the eye turns down to look at it. Thank you.
It was a very nice presentation, Sakshita. Can we move towards the discussion session now? I think we don't have any queries. So I would like you to share your experience about ForOptum.
I would like to thank ForOptum for creating such a wonderful platform and making me as a member of this. It was a great pleasure for me to take this opportunity to share my knowledge. And I would like to thank Deepa ma'am and all my lecturers of Netradama who encouraged me and supported for this. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Sakshita. Thank you, viewers. We will end this session now.